My name's Joe Bargwana. Well, I'm here as a result of being on the committee of Meals on Wheels, and my wife actually has had over 50 years experience of delivering Meals on Wheels. She started in the early days of Meals on Wheels, which of course is celebrating its 60 years here today. So through that involvement, I'm here today to celebrate. Well, it's a wonderful thing, and you know, I think as Steph Cook said in her speech there a moment ago, I think probably knowing as many people as we do from being locals for so many years, you're delivering to people that you know, they want to have a conversation, or you are a bit of a highlight of their day. So there's a lot more than just the meal. You know, it's the connection and interaction between those people and Meals on Wheels. Serving people that you knew. A lot of retired farmers, after they've sold their properties, moved to town. Some of them then, unfortunately, tend to be on their own. And the connection that you have there as a part of being not only a supplier of their meal every day, but keeping an eye on them, I think that probably was as important as anything. And just the service in itself, the fact that it's there every day and, you know, remembering the days when they used to have the hot soup in the very cold winter mornings, and then the occasion where you might have to call and cut up their meals, perhaps help serve it a bit that way. All that was part and parcel of the bigger picture. Yeah. The introduction of frozen meals, that obviously started a new era. I think probably a lot of people now are recipients of getting those sorts of meals from the Meals on Wheels office rather than having them delivered. So in all aspects of actually the meal service has changed to a much bigger version to what it used to be. It was pretty basic initially, but there's so many other opportunities now for people to be serviced from Meals on Wheels. It's so important, and I think the thing is that they are almost like first responders. They see people that are in need of probably a little more care over and above Meals on Wheels. And being a community like we are, that sort of interacts with other aspects of what they may need in terms of being looked after, so they can pass that sort of information on to the relative authorities, whether it be doctors or Mercy Care or whatever, whoever they think may be in need of some extra care. So they're also like the eyes and ears of local people's concerns. That's how important it is. And the volunteers that we've had here over the years, from all sorts and shapes, you know, business houses down to aged pensioners. Margaret Phelan, who was a lucky prize winner today, 41 years she's had as a committee person. And that's the sort of dedication that we get in small towns like this. Yep.